Now student, we are going to solve compound interest question number 6. It has given here, in starting the principal is given 64,000, rate of interest is given 7.5%, either it became change into 15/2%, and the time is given 3 years. It is asking about the compound interest, so I have written 1 plus 1 plus 1. So SI1 means the SI for the first year is P0 multiplying with R multiplying with T upon 100. So P0 means the in starting whatever the principal is given, that is 64,000 multiplying with 15 multiplying with 1 upon 100 multiplying with 2. 15 upon 2 is here, so we will write 15 and upon 2. After the multiplication, 0 divided by 0 and 2 divided 640 into 320. So 320 multiplied with 15, it became 4800. Now, the amount for the first year, I have written here amount 1. And what is the amount 1 that will be? What is the amount 1 that will be the principal for the second year? So P0 plus SI1 is equal to 64,000 plus 4800, it became rupees 68,800. Now as I have told you, this amount 1 will be principal for the second year. So I have written P1 is equal to 68,800. SI2 is equal to P1 into R into T upon 100. So is equal to 68,800 multiplying with 15 multiplying with 1 divided by 100 multiplying with 2. So here 0 divided by 0 and it becomes 688 multiplying with 15. So 2 divided 688, it becomes 344. After the multiplication and multiplication of 15 and 344, it became 5160. So as I have told you, whatever the amount will be there, that will be principal for the next year. So in the same way I have written principal 2, either amount 2 means amount 2 means amount for the second year. So it became principal 1 plus SI2. Principal 1 is given 68,800 rupees plus 5160 rupees. It has become added and became 73,960 rupees. This became amount 2. And for the amount, either the principal for the third year. So we have to find out the SI for the third year. Then we have to write P2 into R into T upon 100. Here P2 is given 73,960. So 73,960 multiplying with 15 multiplying with 1 divided by 100 multiplying with 2 is equal to 5547. Now we have to add amount. We have to get the amount for the third year. So amount 3 means amount for the third year, it has given the principal P2 plus whatever the SI3 we have got. P2 is given 73,960, which is added with 5547. It became 79,507 will be amount. Whenever it will ask about the CI, then CI is equal to compound amount minus principal. Compound amount is given 79,507 and the principal, starting principal is given 64,000. Subtract it became 507, 9 minus 4, 5, 7 minus 6, 1. Means rupees 15,507 rupees became compound interest on 64,000 rupees at rate of 7.5% for 3 years. In question number 7, it has given Divakar deposited a sum of rupees 6,250 at rate of 8% per annum. But it in the Allahabad, it has given for the 1 year, but it is compounded half yearly. it is compounded half yearly. So if half yearly is given, so you can think how many half years in a 1 year. So 2 half years, 2 6 months. So we can write it 2 years, like 2 years we can write. And 8% per annum it has given, but it is telling that half yearly, so rate of interest will also decrease, it will be half, so 4% per annum it became, and the rest of the process will same. It has given 2 years, but we will write like this, 1 plus 1 year. So firstly we have to find the SI. SI1 is equal to P0 multiplying with R multiplying with T upon 100. So P0 is given 6250, rate of interest is given 4%, 1 upon 100. So it is very easy, directly you divide 0, it became 62.5 into 4, multiply it, 4 5s are 22, 4 2s are 8 to 10 1, 4 6s are 24 125. It became rupees 250 became SI on the 6250 for the first 6 months. So amount 1 is equal to P0 plus SI 1 is equal to, P0 is given 6250 plus 250. Now it has been added here, 6250 is added with, so it becomes 6500 rupees. 6500 rupees became our new principal, it became the principal 1. So SI2 we have to find. SI2 is equal to P1 into R into T upon 100 is equal to, P1 is given 6500 multiplying 4% multiplying 1 upon 100, so it became 24 to 26, it became 260 rupees. 4 5s are 22, 4 6s are 24 to 26 rupees. So here it became rupees 260 as the simple interest. So we have to find the amount for the second year. Amount for second year, either amount 2 is equal to principal 1 plus SI 2. So it became 6500 plus 260. It became 6760 rupees became compound amount. Whenever it will ask for the SI, sorry, CI, CI is equal to compound amount minus principal. Compound amount is given 6750 and the principal is given 6250. So 50 0, it became rupees 500 became the compound interest on 6250 rupees at 8% per annum for 1 year.